In this post-staining video, we're going to compare uranyless with uranyl acetate and also benchtop staining and microwave staining. The microwave we'll be using is the EMS 9000. And if you use this for regular processing, it's going to function exactly the same. I have a water load in there, so I maintain a temperature. We're going to be doing 37 degrees versus room temperature. And we go to the benchtop. Let's go over there and see what that goes. I have my 2.5% uranyl acetate and 50% ethanol, and then also the uranyless. The uranyless comes in a bottle that's taken with a syringe. The 2.5 uranyl acetate was made up and it's covered because it does react with light, although I find I don't have to worry about that during the staining procedure. So to take this out, I'm just going to insert a little bit of air and extract some of the uranyless out and just put a drop. I have a piece of parafilm in a staining dish or a petri dish, and it's nice. This uranyless, you don't have to worry about contamination. I've never had any when I'm using this. And I'm going to save that because I'll be doing the microwave. When I do my uranyl acetate, I like to use a glass pipette versus the plastic transfer pipette. So I'm using a Pasteur pipette. I'm just going to draw some up in there. And then I'm just going to place again a drop of the UA on the parafilm. And I'll save that also for the microwave procedure. It'll be coming up. We're going to cover that, and then I'm going to do benchtop staining for 10 minutes. Many people use 7, some people use 20, so it's always difficult. I'll put my uranyl acetate grid on there, and then I'm going to put the uranyless on the other side. And remember to float those on top. Don't drop your grid from on high, otherwise they could stain on both sides, and you only want it to float on the section side down. So here I'm in front of the microwave, and you can see the parafilm in my petri dish. I'll just put my drop of uranyless there. It doesn't matter how big, one drop is a drop. And then I'll also put the uranyl acetate in there. And float the grid on top. If you section your sections on the dull side, then put it on the dull side. If you pick them up on the bright side or brassy side, do that floating down. We'll put this in the microwave, and I have my time set, and we're going to take a look. I'm going to do it for 37 degrees, and I'm doing it for 2 minutes. I've already started, obviously, and I'm running 85% power, and so that should work out very well. Our time is up. And we're going to take those out. While my benchtop is still staining, I'm going to be able to take these out and rinse them before the benchtop are ready. So I just have 3 beakers of water. I'm going to pick my grid up here and rinse them. Some people do some ethanol if they use ethanolic uranyl acetate in the first rinse, but I just use water and it tends to work out pretty well. Now I obviously am zipping through this in terms of in my video. I rinse those for about 15 dips each. I just get tired of watching 15 dips on the video, so I've sped that up a little bit. You can see I'm not this fast generally. And as I put that down, again, not the section side down, and I always use a piece of parafilm in between that. So I have my microwave samples there on my grid, and my room temperature is now ready to go. So I have those microwave ones there. Now I'm going to rinse the room temperature ones. And again, I have the Uranyless and a urinal acetate. And we'll do my fast dip procedure here again. I know it's exciting watching rinsing grids. And when you rinse them, always go up and down. Don't go back and forth, because otherwise you could break that thin membrane that is your section with the force of the moving it sideways. So always just dip it up and down. The Uranyless and the urinal acetate, and then the lead citrate dispenser, which is coming up. And this is really nice because you don't have to worry about contamination. So I have my grids, and I'm going to use this lead citrate. And I have found that when I do this, we just squeeze out a couple drops onto the parafilm. When I do this, I haven't found the need to use sodium hydroxide in my stain, which is very nice because sodium hydroxide always is a pain to work with. So I have my drops in there, and I'm just going to put my grids on there. Again, the sodium hydroxide is just insidious. You drop a pellet of sodium hydroxide somewhere and you think you rinse it off and wash it up, and it seems like it always forms a nice white layer a day or two later. So you have to neutralize that then with a mild acid. Again, section side down. And I'm going to do this again for 10 minutes. There we go. And then I'll go over and let's see what we do at the microwave. I have my lead citrate in there already. We're just going to do the exact same thing. I know post-staining isn't particularly exciting, but it is the one area that seems to be the most problematic in terms of potential precipitates and things like that on your sections. It's a real pain to go through all of the processing and sectioning and then have your sections have contamination from either urinal acetate, but most normally lead citrate. I'm going to do that. And again, I'm going to do the 2 minutes at 37 degrees for the microwave and 85% power. So we're up to 37 degrees and the timer is coming down, and we're all done now. Time-lapse photography, and we're going to take those out and perform the same rinsing that we've done ad infinitum. And I'll speed that up a little bit more. And then finally, I'm tired of showing that. We're going to do that for the urinal acetate one from the microwave. And then we're going to do the same for the benchtop. And you can see I got tired of that. So repeat the washing cycle for room temperature grids. The results are that the Uranyless gave very good contrast, with the urinal acetate providing slightly better contrast. The room temperature and the microwave gave very comparable results, with only the time being a factor. And the most interesting was with the sodium hydroxide not being used with the lead still gave a good stain.